two politicians actually judging women on rape, on saying boys will be boys, which is what Mulayam Singh Yadav, the Samajwadi Party, has said. I mean, the party has proven that it's simply retrograde when it comes to issues of women's safety. Boys will be boys, they may make mistakes, Mulayam Singh Yadav says. His party colleague Abu Azmi takes it one step further and says, hang both the woman and the rapist, because a woman having premarital or extramarital sex should be punished. Now, this is what is going on in our election campaign right now. The National Commission of Women has also issued a notice. The Election Commission is being asked to look at these comments as well, not just Azam Khan and Amit Shah, but also the kinds of comments politicians are making about women. Take a look.
ऐसे कानूनों को बदलने की कोशिश की जाएगी, दुरुपयोग करने वालों को सजा देंगे और झूठ रिपोर्ट करने वालों को भी सजा का प्रावधान किया।
First, this outrageous comment. Then, a half-hearted attempt at damage control.
लेकिन देशों को फंसाने के भी उसके पक्ष में है। समाजवादी पार्टी से ज्यादा महिलाओं की कोई नहीं करता है। सम्मान आप नहीं करते, दोष मुझसे करते।
But by then, Mulayam Singh Yadav's remarks on protecting rapists had already triggered a wave of outrage. Unfazed by the growing anger, the Samajwadi Party chief's comments inspired his party man to make another grotesque comment. Abu Azmi, in charge of the Samajwadi Party's Maharashtra unit, bizarrely invoked Islam to demand women who were raped should also be punished.
If a girl wants to go to her own will, किसी के साथ जाती है तो इस्लाम में दोनों को सजा दी जाती है। मैंने रिलीजन की बात किया।
Within hours, his own family sprung into action. His son Farhan Azmi, who's contesting the Lok Sabha polls from Mumbai North Central, distanced himself.
Consensual sex is a matter which is very private between a couple, between two adults. In this regard, I have spoken to him. I have told him that you know rape is a subject that needs to be discussed and debated. I stand against each and every person who is taking part, you know, in insulting a woman.
While Abu Azmi's daughter-in-law, a Bollywood actor, tweeted her embarrassment. These comments by the two veteran leaders, a shameful insult to the battle fought by these parents. In 2012, their daughter, a 23-year-old student, became a symbol of national outrage after she was fatally gang-raped in a moving bus in Delhi.
पीएम पद के उम्मीदवार भी हैं। जब इतने बड़े लेवल के लोग इतनी नीची सोच रखेंगे तो उस देश का क्या हो सकता है।
Both the Election Commission and the National Commission for Women have now issued a notice to Mulayam Singh Yadav.
बलात्कार को एक जुर्म बताने के बजाय उसको हल्का करके आप एक साधारण सी गलती बता दें, ये उनकी तरफ से बिल्कुल बहुत दिक्कत तलब बात है।
इट इज वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेट दैट व्हेन लीडर्स टॉक इन सच इनसेंसिटिव मैनर अबाउट ग्रेव इश्यूज लाइक रेप।
द व्यू ऑफ श्री मुलायम सिंह यादव इज एब्सोल्युटली अबहोरेंट एंड शॉकिंग।
When 49% of India's voting population comprises women, Mulayam Singh Yadav's comments once again highlight the long battle that women's rights organizations have been fighting for years. One that not only calls for more strict laws, but also for changing the patriarchal mindset. With Anand Zanane and Saurabh Gupta in New Delhi, Keti Angre for NDTV. Right, well, we still have Nalin Kohli and Amiben Yagnik with us, as well as Bhukkal Nawab from the Samajwadi Party. For more on this, Vrinda Grover also joining us. And from Kolkata, Suzanne Jordan, the Park Street rape survivor, who is with us on the show. But before we go to any of them, Farhan Azmi, Abu Azmi's son, we want to ask you, you distance yourself from your father's comments, yet the Samajwadi Party chief has also made extremely problematic comments about women and rape.
To start with, I would like to clarify that both my senior leaders have uttered a few things which are objectionable, which I completely stand against. And I believe if given an opportunity, they will come out and clarify and if need be even apologize, because I think it has definitely hurt a lot of sentiments of the yuva, of the women, and not just of the country but even our party, the youth organization, as well as our families, which include the daughter-in-laws of the SP family and also the extended families. So I regret, and I would like to reiterate that as far as Samajwadi Party, even my Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav reiterated that if any rapist is given the death penalty, the sentence must be honoured, and we propose that not just once, but they should be hanged 100 times.
Right, Farhan, you know, the point is your leaders have said this, you have condemned it. I'm sure other young Samajwadi Party leaders might also agree with you. But nonetheless, this is the leadership you're working with. This is the party you represent. What does it mean for you personally to work with people who make such comments, including your father?
I would like to state my seniors have brought us up with utmost, with full moral responsibilities. We have fought for acid attack victim Preeti Rathi. Nobody from any party even came to see her when she was lying at the Masina hospital after she was acid attacked. So, and Mr. Akhilesh Yadav has supported the women by distributing laptops, by giving them, you know, funds to further their studies. So this is proof. We've even taken Pulan Devi to the parliament, who was raped and brutalized by the local goons. And that is the example of Mulayam Singh Yadav. Some statements were made at a wrong place. A public rally is not a place to address a subject like rape. We must come together. At least there's an issue hiding behind his statement, which is the consensual sex. Today there are plenty, thousands of rape cases falsely being implicated on men. Last week a Marathi person committed suicide with his entire family because his wife claimed rape, and she said he was harassing her and she went missing. When she was found later after a week in Bangalore, no false cases.
Nobody is disputing that false cases are also registered, but the question is not about false cases. The question is when women are victimized by this kind of misogyny,
exactly, Maya,
in society,
these statements
should politicians
wrong.
Be making
I agree.
Such remarks?
I express my regret.
Yeah.
I express my regret with full force, and so everybody in my party joins me. Even my father will come out sooner or later and clarify, and if need be even apologize, because he does not mean what is being misconstrued. He said something in haste. He was about to get off for a public rally and he said something in haste. Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav used a public rally. Both the situations were not apt to discuss and give your opinion.
So
rape
you are
is a subject that needs the entire country, especially the women and the youth force.
So you are hopeful that both these leaders of your party will actually come out and apologize for these comments?
Yes, I request them. I plead to Mr. my Netaji. I love him to death. I have grown up with his ideologies, and I assure my youth, my workers, my volunteers, my voters that we are with them. If a rapist is convicted, I propose that it must be hanged not once but 100 times. At the same time, I also ask Priya Dutt and MP Murli Milind Deora, why have they not addressed this issue ever? You know, why didn't they ever take this up with their constituency?
Right.
Why is Gopal Khanda not being given death sentence? He's a congressman.
Okay.
He is raped Geetika Sharma, murdered her. There's a suicide note. Why is nobody talking about that?
Right.
I admit there's been a mistake in giving these statements. We must correct ourselves. The new generation of Samajwadi Party is ready to transform itself.
Okay, Farhan,
please give us a chance. Please, please, please give us another chance.
Fine, we'll take your word for it. Farhan Azmi apologizing on behalf of his father, of his party, and saying they will also come out and make statements, hopefully to sort of take back the kind of retrograde comments that they had made, and not justifying them in a sense. Farhan Azmi saying that he is deeply apologetic and that the younger generation of his party does not certainly have the same thoughts. Farhan Azmi, thanks very much for joining us on the show tonight. We have our other panelists on the discussion as well. Bukal Nawab, I want to ask you first, actually. You've heard Farhan Azmi actually condemn, in a sense, your own party's leadership and the kind of comments that they have made against women. Do you agree with Farhan Azmi?
I am agree, Farhan Azmi, but agar koi rape karta hai, is tarike se hota hai, generally koi is tarah ka koi attack karta hai, to usko zarur zarur phansi de dena chahiye, और उसको फांसी नहीं बल्कि शेर के पिंजरे में छोड़ देना चाहिए। उसके साथ जितना भी आप कर सकते हैं, जो भी आप कारोबार है वो पूरे निकाल सकते हैं, लेकिन जो हमारे राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष मुलायम सिंह यादव जी ने कहा है, उन्होंने कहा है कि एक दोस्त एक फ्रेंड एक दूसरे फ्रेंड के साथ में, एक दोस्त दूसरे दोस्त के साथ में रहता है और उसके अंदर मतभेद अगर हो जाते हैं, मतभेद होने के बाद अगर कोई घटना होती है घटती है
नवाब उसके बाद एफआईआर करता है। लड़के लड़के होते हैं और गलतियां हो जाती हैं, उनका ये कहना था, ये कुछ और, जो आप कह रहे हैं और है
नहीं, जो हम कह रहे हैं वही है। आप दिखा दिए विजुअल, जो हम कह रहे हैं वही है। उन्होंने दोस्त कहा है, उन्होंने दोस्तों में मतभेद कहा है और मतभेद के बाद घटना कही है। अगर ये नहीं कही है तो हम एमएनसी चीफ से इस्तीफा दे देंगे।
घटना रेप
मतभेद के बाद एफआईआर हुई है, एफआईआर होने के बाद में अगर किसी को फांसी में चढ़ा दिया जाता है तो ये गलत है, इट इज टोटली रॉन्ग।
ठीक है, नहीं होना चाहिए।
हाँ, उनको 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 सजा देना जरूरी है।
ओके, इट इज अनिवार्य।
लेकिन
All right, Bukal Nawab, I'm going to take this away from the politicians to Suzette Jordan and Brinda Grover. Suzette Jordan, I want to ask you first. We are in an election. What do you make of these kinds of comments you're hearing from our political classes? Bukal Nawab, sir, 1 minute. आप और लोगों को भी बात करने दीजिए. 1 minute.
I want only 1 minute.
No, I've asked Suzette Jordan a question. Mr. Nawab, you'll have to let her answer. Just one moment.
भी
बात करने दीजिए, मैंने किसी और से सवाल पूछा है, 1 मिनट
छोड़िए, कट करिए।
यस सुजैत, गो अहेड।
या आई थिंक दिस इज एक्सट्रीमली हॉरिफिक एंड हॉरेंडस, एंड आई थिंक पॉलिटिक्स कंज्यूम्स द माइंड ऑफ अ मैन सो मच। The greed for power and being in control, you just trample over humanity. You don't care what you say. You just say just because it suits your means, fits your end. And I think reiterating your words after you've spoken them has been happening a lot recently from a lot of these politicians, which is really, really, really sad.
Okay, Suzette Jordan, really sad. You're the best place to actually comment on what these people are saying. Brinda Grover, I want to ask you, when you hear Mulayam Singh Yadav, when you hear Abu Azmi talk, and then when you hear Farhan Azmi, his son, actually, in a sense, almost embarrassed about the kind of comments his father has made, because there is a younger generation as well, which is trying to bridge gaps and bridge thinking. What do you feel when you hear all this?
You know, I'm not sure whether we should take the younger Azmi on face value. And the reason why I say this is that the constituency that he is seeking votes from is an urban metropolitan Mumbai. And the constituency that Mulayam Singh Yadav was appealing to, and it was not a mistake that the issue was raised at a political rally, it was meant to be raised at a political rally. Mulayam Singh Yadav is a very, very seasoned politician. He knows exactly what should be said at what moment. He is appealing to a constituency which he thinks that this is what will garner him votes. Mm-hmm. So there is going to be no apology coming from him. There have been many spokespersons of this party giving spins to what Abu Azmi and Mulayam Singh Yadav have said. Some are trying to make out that, oh, now Mulayam Singh Yadav is against capital punishment. Really? Abu Azmi said, let us whip men and women who have consensual live-in relationships, which under the domestic violence law are protected by law, and women are given protection against violence.
Okay, Brinda.
What is the person? Just a minute, please. Yeah. We waited for very long to be spoken to. The person now is saying they should be hanged 100 times over. Somebody saying throw them to the dogs. Right. I also want to make the point that all this is playing out to different constituencies. There is nothing about women involved here. There is no respect for women, no concern for women's
and
issues.
And you're saying that we are at a very, very
I want to
for the
yes
Rajwadi
yes
party.
And I want no I am saying it across political parties, and I want to make a link. I strongly disagree with what you were also saying. I think it's the height of naivety to say that, and please remember a very old slogan of the feminist movement, the personal is political, to say that there is no public interest involved in Modi giving no information and only under compulsion of law informing us that he has a wife There is a public interest involved. I, as a voter, I want to look at what is the gender index of each of my candidates.
Okay.
What do I see? A man who has deserted, abandoned his wife, doesn't inform us. Is this the transparent good governance
we're talking about?
Nalin, we are not prying into the bedroom.
These are public interest issues. Let Nalin Kohli respond to that, Vrinda Grover. One moment. Let Nalin Kohli respond to that. Mr. Kohli.
Well, I have three comments. One is, of course, on the last comment of Vrindaji. That's her viewpoint. I put across my viewpoint earlier to that. We can agree to disagree to it also. There may be views about how we approach a subject. So I'm not going to
really drag
an issue onto that. Well, I mean, yes, ma'am, certainly, as I would also respect a woman's privacy. Because, you know, there's a presumption in what you're saying. And
this
I think,
is not
on the other hand, we should not presume
that's it.
Well, I mean, if you're looking at it from Mr. Modi's side, I'm sorry, ma'am. If you're looking at it from Mr. Modi's perspective, you must also look at it from Yashoda Ben's perspective. So that's why I'm saying I'm not going to drag this into an issue yet.
This is the requirement of law. This is the requirement of law.
It's a requirement post 13th. Well, ma'am, I mean, on a law subject too. As a lawyer, I'll point it out also. It's post September 13th.
It's post September 2013. This is not about privacy. Do not try to mislead the people of this country.
I mean, it's your viewpoint. I am not misleading, madam, and I take offense to you saying so.
That is the viewpoint of the Supreme Court.
Well, I mean, you are free to. No, well, you are free to. You are free to, as a citizen of India. You are free to, as a citizen of India. You are free to, as a citizen of India, to have a viewpoint. As am I. As
am I too.
So I think, you know, we will leave this at that.
Fine, Vrinda Grover and Nalin.
Well, I mean, it's mandated, so it's there now. I would like to say a couple of things on the Mulayam Singh Yadav issue.
Can we please expand this to beyond Narendra Modi's marital status?
Absolutely.
This is about women's safety. Mulayam Singh Yadav, one moment. Amin Yagnik, you are hearing this debate.
I haven't answered. One minute.
Yes.
1 minute, ma'am. I haven't spoken my bit. It got pulled into Mr. Modi's issue.
Okay.
I want to make my comment about the Samajwadi Party.
Right. Yeah.
And I want to say it unequivocally. I think it's a sickening sentence. It's a sickening mindset. It's a mindset that does not take into account a woman's mental, physical, psychological trauma or violation.
Right.
I think it's insensitive to the whole woman community. And this is not one-off. I do agree with Vrindaji that there is much more to it. And I will point out, this was a rally in Moradabad. When he said, "Hamare ye teen ladke," I am sorry to say, this is communalism where you are also denigrating a whole community. It's not like that. I think a rapist is a rapist, and that's how it's meant to be treated.
Okay.
And we have to be more sensitive in our society.
Okay, so let's get the Congress in on this as well. Amiben Yagnik, do you agree with what Nalin Kohli is saying? As far as the Samajwadi Party is concerned, it's not just about what the comments that he's made about women. He's also communalizing the issue. He's also basically giving boys a free rein and to behave in any manner that they may want to, saying ladke ladke hote hain aur galtiyan ho jayengi.
See, Maya, the issue here is that whatever Mr. Mulayam Singh has said shows very clearly that he has no regard for women's dignity. He has no regard for law. He is making a sweeping statement that boys are boys and mistakes can be made. He does not know the very much seriousness of the violence that takes place against women and how women become victims. So here is a person who has made a statement with no regard even for the constitution, has no idea or any understanding about what is women's dignity. So forget about the communal part. But he also says that, well, we'll change the law as if it's a child's play, and just takes and talks a lot about taking the other systems lightly. So here I think we should be very serious in saying that not only does he apologize, but he also has to give a message that he's going to change his mindset. Political leaders cannot speak like that. They have to have an understanding of the society, of women's dignity,
without understanding that they cannot make these kind of statements. On this issue, Amiben Yagnik and Nalin Kohli, can you agree?
Absolutely. There's no question about it. It's about women and it's about Indian. It's about women in general. It's about every Indian, I think. It's about rights, and how can we disagree? Every right-thinking person, irrespective of the political party, can have no other view. I also want to say I'm a little disappointed with the foreign-educated son and Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh and his wife, who's also Dimple, is an educated lady and a member of parliament. How come they've kept silence when we did see Farhan and his wife, Aisha, come out at least clearly on this?
Well, those are clearly important questions you're raising. We're completely running out of time on this debate. But Suzanne Jordan, I want to end this with your last thoughts. This Farhan Azmi has come out and said he apologizes for what his father has said. He's hopeful, or he's certainly hoping for, I don't know whether hopeful is the right word, that his party leadership is also going to come out and make things clear. But we heard Bhukkar Nawaz speak earlier, and we're not so sure whether that hope is going to yield any results. Nonetheless, we see this breakdown always, even the issue of women's safety, a deeply political one. Brinda Grover also pointing it out. Do you feel that for women like you, there's a lot that's said and nothing really ultimately delivered at the end of the day when you see the legal system? Or do you, are you feeling more hopeful today than you were 6 months ago, say?
Honestly speaking, I don't feel hopeful at all, because these are the people in power. These are the people who are meant to be in control of the system, of the laws. And the kind of messages they give out at rallies actually are messages to many of the rapists who are waiting for their next attack. So definitely not. And I think our fight gets stronger from this point.
Right. Suzanne Jordan, Brinda Grover, Nalin Kohli, Ami Ben Yagnik. Unfortunately, we're completely out of time on this show tonight. Thank you all very much for joining us. We try to pack a lot into our buck stops here tonight, this Friday night, but lots and lots of news in election season. So stay with us. NDTV remains election central for all of you. All the news and updates follow after a quick break.